Welcome to 1 Minute KizKit, where we answer your KizKit questions and share KizKit tips and tricks. The question is, how do I manage lots of parameters? In a previous video, we saw how we could use parameters to define a circuit and then assign values to those parameters later. For example, here I've created a circuit with parameter phi, and I'm assigning it the value 0, just as an example. If you're working with lots of parameters, you'll probably want to use KizKit's parameter vector, and you can mostly treat this as if it were just a list of parameters. For example, this parameter vector has two elements, and I'll use both of these in the circuit, referencing them using their index. And I'll set both of these values to 0, just as an example. One thing to bear in mind is that each parameter vector element can only belong to one parameter vector, and you can find this vector using its vector attribute. You might sometimes need to handle circuits that have parameters that you don't have references to. For example, here I'm creating a parameterized circuit from the circuit library, and you can see it has 16 parameters that we didn't define. If you want to access a circuit's parameters so that you can assign values to them, you can use the circuit's parameters attribute. This attribute is actually a list of all the parameters or parameter vector elements used in that circuit. And from this, we can get the parameter vector that was used to create that circuit. Finally, you might see circuits that use many parameters or parameter vectors. You can separate these different parameters out by filtering through the quantum circuit's parameters attribute. The first argument of the filter function is another function that takes an element and returns true if it should stay, or false if it should be filtered out. My function looks for parameter vector elements whose parent parameter vector has name theta. This gives us a list of all the elements of theta that we used in this circuit. If you have a question you want answered, then please leave it in the comments. And if you found this video useful, you can subscribe for more 1 Minute KizKit and other quantum and KizKit related videos. Thanks for watching and goodbye.